Hey, hi, welcome guys. Welcome back to our channel, which is Pybron.
So today we are going to discuss about how to install APM in Ubuntu operating system. I think many of requests I got from many of the learners who are facing to install this APM. So guys, I can agree these things. It's a very painful job. And literally whenever I also used to install in my local system, I also faced the many kind of issues, so that I feel I should make some video in a very generic way and very step by step. I will show you how to install the APM in Ubuntu operating system. And if you can install this in Ubuntu operating system, it's the same procedure for Mac as well. And for Windows, I already created a video. You can watch that, Windows user, but whoever using the Ubuntu or Mac, they can follow this video. So my name is Rajesh Thakur, and I came up with the APM installation in your local system, Ubuntu local system. So what are the three step? I converted this complete installation part into the three part. This video might get extended, but don't worry, it's a complete scratch part. In this laptop, I haven't installed any APM so far. So I'm going to install in front of you. So first thing, we have to install the JDK. And make sure whenever you are installing the JDK, don't install OpenJDK. It might create some issues. So better to install the Oracle JDK. So how to install the Oracle JDK? So for installing this Oracle JDK, you can go to the official website of Oracle system, and there is an option of the download JDK. Just click on this. It's a JDK 8 is showing, right? So sorry, JDK 16 is showing. So make sure you are installing JDK 8. Okay. So let's see whether if I'm changing here, will it work? Yes, it should work. Okay, yes, it is going to work. So which file you should install? As you are using the Linux, then Linux 64-bit compressed archive file. This is the file. Just download this. It will ask the Oracle credentials, so you can create your credentials. It's a kind of how to create a Facebook account. It's like the same way I having that account. So yes, I already having the account. I am going to log in with my account. And you can also log in with, you can create account if you don't having that. So it is getting download. I'm going to pause this video. Just it will take some time to install and to download it. Once it will complete the downloading, I will resume my recording. Okay, my downloading part has been done. So now the coming to the installation part, how to install the Oracle JDK and Ubuntu. And also I will show you how to set the path. So for installing those things, just you have to create one folder, JVM folder inside of userlib. So this is that command to create. Just open your terminal. And this is my terminal. Just let me come out from this and just a minute, let me open new terminal so it will be easy for me. So what you can do, just Control Shift V, and I'm going to create this new folder. So you can go there and cd user lib and jvm, and you can see it's a JDK 1.8 is already there, right? So I guess, yeah, it got downloaded. Let me remove these things so it will be better. So cd sudo rm minus rf. Firstly, I'm going to remove these things. So I got remove this. Now I will pass this thing. Now what I'll do, I will just extract this file inside this. I just downloaded inside my download section, right? So what you can do, so this tar file I have just downloaded, and this is the tar file, and I'm going to extract that tar file inside of userlib jvm folder. So make sure you just come out from there and your downloading has been done. You just downloaded your JDK inside of download section, right? So just check it out where it got downloaded. It got downloaded here, right? So what you can do, just go there and keep it inside of download section. So it will be good. Yes, so it got downloaded. So what you can do, so just paste that command which to extract the file. This is tar.zgf, and paste this command. And here, make sure this file name should be, it's a file name is different, right? So what you can do, just press JDK and press tab, Okay, it is not there. Why it is not showing a suggestion? Because I am not in the download folder directory, right? So I have to go in download directory, and then what you can do, just once again you can press this command, and just a minute, let me remove these things. And this is the OpenJDK, I guess it is showing. Just a minute, let me rename this, get the name of this, control A, control C, and paste it here. Yes, and it will extract there. It is getting extracted, right? So now you can go there and cd-user-lib-jvm and ls command. If you will do now, all this file is came right here, cd-jdk, you can give here jdk and go there, ls command, you can execute, and everything is there, right? All those things are there now. Once this part has been done, so what you have to do, you have to our JDK pass, JDK installation has been done. Now only thing is that we have to set the path, right? So for the setting the path, we have to do something in our bash rc file. So for setting the path, what you can do, just go to your etc environment file folder, you can just create new terminal and cd, and here you can do sudo vi etc environment folder, and just go there. It will ask the password. Just a minute, let me put the password, and here everything is set only. So just press I command to insert anything. You can open this file in the gedit mode also, that should be fine. Nano mode, any editor you can use. And in my case, the path is already set. Only thing is that Java path we have to set, right? So what I can do, I will just copy these things and I will paste it here so that it should be fine. So 1 minute, let me go here, and this things is fine. But in my case, I have to check this file name, right? So what is that file name? File name is this one, JDK 1.8.291. Copy this and go here. What is that file name? JDK 1.8.281, right? So you have to change this file name here, 281. You have to keep the 291 and control shift V. That's fine. I guess everything is fine. Then, okay. So save this, escape shift colon WQ is the command. Escape shift colon WQ is to save the file. Save this file. And once again, if you want to check that, okay, if you want to make these reflections, what you have to do, you have to press the source command. After doing the VI, you have to run the source command, source etc environment, then it will check all the configuration is properly set or not. So what you can do, just press echo echo dollar, whether the path has been set or not, java_home. Yes, can you see this? This path has been set properly. And now if you will check the Java hyphen, okay. So, okay, this path has been set. Now, next thing is that what to do in just a minute. So path has been set, then we have to tell new Java has been came into the machine, right? So if you already having some Java like or OpenJDK you have installed, then I told you, right, the machine has to be configured with the Oracle JDK. So if previously any Java has been installed, then you have to intentionally tell to the machine new JDK came into the picture, so use that only. So what you can do, JDK 1.8, and here you just mention this 291 bin Java and user lib Java and alternative, yes, update. Okay, what is saying? Sudo update install user bin Java install. Okay, update alternative help program. This is fine. Yes, use update alternative. Okay, sorry, let me check this. It should work. JVM bin Java, yes, this is fine. And user bin JVM, yes. Okay, anyway, this is just for server configuration. Maybe that's what it is not showing. But anyway, I will check this set. I will set this Java. Yes, it got updated. Now, if you will check the Java hyphen version. Okay, it's not recognizing. Okay, so two more thing we have to do. What you can do, you can go to your bash rc file, and there also we have to update. Okay, so what you can do, just go to your bash rc file cd came, it came out from here, and cd vi sudo vi, and same path we have to set in the bash rc file also. So go there and bash rc, and here you have to set the java path. Conda path has been set, so you have to set the java path. So let me, so we have to set the path of bash rc in bash rc file also. So this is my bash rc file, and go to the insert mode, and here what you can do, just a minute, you can just set your path at the down of this line, complete line, and let me set this path, and here just copy paste this line of code, export, control c and control shift v. You can press this. And let me set this as well. Indentation issues are there. So okay. So yes, 21. And then this one is also, we have two indentation issues are there. Yeah, fine. So here in our case, the file name is something different, right? So you can go to the this cd user lib and jvm and ls command. If you are pressing, this is my file name 18.0.91, and copy this and just go here and change this file name, okay, to 91, and that's fine, and save it, escape shift colon wq, and save this file, and you have to execute the source command. So urc source command to make it reflect at the runtime, and save it. It got run, and now what you can do, just close this terminal and create a new terminal. So, and here you can paste the Java icon version. Yes, cool. Enjoy. Your Java path has been set, and Java is running as well, right? So fine, and you can see our JDK 8 has been installed properly. Now next point was what? So far we had done this installation, Oracle JDK installation we have done. I will give this command in my description of this video. You can go through that. Now next part of this video is to install the Android Studio. Okay, install Android is not Android installation, sorry, my bad, it should be Android Studio installation. So it will take time, it's a very painful, guys. So again, for that I had created a separate document. I will share this document in my description. So just go through this website. This is the website. Open this website and download the Android Studio. So it will take time. What you can do, Android Studio download is download Android Studio. Just go there. Okay, this is the download, and automatically it will take your Linux operating system. Its operating system, it will automatically take. If you are opening this link in your window, then it will take a right now you can see Linux 64, right? It automatically take that file name, and if you are opening this link in your window or Mac, then automatically it will take that operating system, and based on your operating system it will give you the file. And just download this Android Studio and check this terms and condition link and just to install this. It will take time, as you can see 883 MB size it is. So I will pause this video until it is getting download. So once the downloading has been done, I will show you how to install this Android Studio and how to, you know, set the path, right? So yeah. Okay, guys, you can see my Android Studio is almost has been downloaded. Yes, it got downloaded. Now the thing is that what to do basically. So once the downloading has been done, so what you can do, just extract those things first. Thing is that it's a tar file. So what to do, you have to extract this file and go to the bin directory. So just let me go to this folder where I have been extracted. And okay, it got extracted here. So what I can do, I can just go to the download section only. And I will keep these things here. Okay, so just I'm gonna extract here. Okay, so once the downloading has been done, so what to do, basically, once you download it, you will get your Android Studio in your download folder or wherever. So you can extract this folder, just extract here. And once the extraction has been done, you will get this directory. go there inside of this directory, and let me go there, cd android studio and linux ls, and here cd android studio ls, and cd bin, go to the bin directory ls, and there we have a you know, studio.sh file is there. So what you can do, just to open this studio shell script, studio studio.sh. It will take some time. Okay, do not import anything, and the config installation, okay, just let it to be by default values, and yes, it is downloading all those things and it will install all those packages. Okay, send uses statistics, and I don't want to create next, just click on next and next, and you can choose anything. I always recommend this white black background, just click on next, next, and finish. So now it is getting downloaded and your Android Studio will get installed in a while. So once it, this installation part has been done, then we have to set some path in our local system, like bashrc file and configuration file. There we can directly use these things, right? So we are at the second stage, let it to be installed. So we are at the second point. First point, we had seen how to install the JDK, Oracle JDK, and how to set all this file. And second point, we had seen how to install Android Studio. And also we had seen how to extract those things. So right now we are doing the installation. It will take some time, guys. I will pause this video until it is getting installed. So once the installation part has been done, then I will show you what are the basic configuration need to be done in our bashrc file, that I will show you once this installation part has been done. So it will take some time, don't worry. So meanwhile, I always recommend just make sure you are subscribing our channel so that you will never miss our update. Thank you. Well, I'm going to pause this video. Once this installation has been done, then I will resume my recording. So fine, our Android Studio installation has been done. It took some time, no worries. Anyways, it's finished. So let it to be open once. Okay, so what you can do, just a minute, configure here, SDK manager, anything need to be done? Yes, that's fine. And you can just create new project and you can take a next, next, finish. So let it to be open a new project. Yeah, cool. So our Android Studio has been installed properly. And now what you can do, just go to your terminal, just open new terminal and cd and ls command, you can check, and you will get one in your home directory, this new folder, like an Android folder. If you can go to the cd Android and ls command cd sdk, there is a sdk folders are there, all those folders should be there, platform, tool platform, and all those things should be there. So we have to set this path in our bashrc file. So I had already written the commands how to set those things. Just paste it, this many line of code, in your bashrc file and save this file. Just a minute, let me copy this file, and I guess this is not machine dependencies. So here you can give home Rajesh. This is my pwd, just let me check that pwd. Yes, home. Okay, my pwd is this one, right? Just a minute. My home directory is home OEM, right? So OEM, we have to give the OEM. OEM, and here also we have to give that file OEM. And here also we have to change this OEM. And here also we have to change OEM. Okay, cool. So that's fine. And just copy this. I'm just copying this file things and control C, and go to open your sudo vi bashrc file. Bashrc file and password. Go to here, I command. You can press I command and control C. Yes. And I guess this should be fine. And yeah, save this escape sips colon wp, it will save. Now you can run the source command whenever you are updating anything in your bashrc or any kind of configuration file, then you should apply the source. Okay, so it's done. And now do one thing, just close this terminal and reopen one new terminal so that you can see cd and here you can just type ADB, ADB. Yes, it is getting ADB, ADB devices. Press the commands which we know, ADB devices. Okay, maybe spelling mistakes are there. So yes, my bad. So you can see right now nothing is connected, so it is coming. So ADB command is running successfully. All those things are working fine. I will show you ADB command as well. So what you can do, just you can download the emulator and you can do all those things. It's a fine, it's a way up to you. So create a virtual machine. I guess this is already has been created here for me. Unable to locate the ADB. And now if I execute this command, it should show me. Yeah, can you see this? This ADB is able to identify my device, right? So yeah, so few things has been done. What are the things has been done? Two, so far we have done our Oracle install, JDK installation, and Android Studio installation has been done. Now the important thing is to install the APM. So for installing the APM, I got a very good website, guys. Just follow that website, and this is the Confused Coder website is there. So just follow this website. This is the very good website to install the APM. And yes, it works for me. Means always I used to prefer this website. So just copy these commands and one by one just execute these things in your terminal. So fine, what you can do, just press these things and install it up. So let me install all those things. It's getting installed. It will take some time, don't worry. Let me close this thing because it's taking my RAM, because emulator is taking much time. And make sure whenever you are installing APM Android Studio, make sure you should have at least 8 GB of RAM, otherwise it's a very panic to install. Okay, so next is we have to install the Linux Brew. You can use the npm node package manager. In my case, means most of the 90% time I face many issues. NPM is not working at all for me. So I will always prefer go with the brew command, and brew will always be work. Okay, so just install the Linux brew and it will work. If this will also not work, then I will show you the another way. There is a three way to install the APM. One is npm, another is brew command, and brew will install the anyway. Backend will install the node package manager and node at all, and node will, npm will install the APM, right? So another thing is that if this will also not work, then you can install the APM desktop. This will anyway, it will work. Okay, so go with the step by step. Npm will not work for sure. You will face many issues to install the npm. So just install the Linux brew, guys, and it will work. Means 99.9% cases, I feel it will work. Only 0.4% chances are there it will not work. So it is getting installed. Brew will take some time because it's a big library. You can see many of the packages are getting installed. So I can wait. Meanwhile, I'm pausing this video. Okay, fine. Our Linux Brew has been installed. Now the thing is that we have to set the Linux Brew path in our bashrc. So what you can do, just open your bashrc file, sudo vi tilde sign dot bashrc. Bashrc, and here we have to set the path, insert this. So guys, you can use any editor, like gEditor, Nano, and any command, any editor you can use. I always used to prefer this BI, so I always going through this. So just copy this command and paste it here and save this file. Escape shift colon WQ, and it will save it at. And again, you have to start the source command. You have to run the source command, SURC source command, and so that the things will get clear. So it should run without this. Okay, fine. So our Linux brew has been installed and we set the path as well. Now we have to install the GCC. So brew install GCC. So just install this brew GCC. So again, it will take some time. It is getting installed. Okay. So I will give this document in my description of this video. You can just go through that. All those my setup, this file, as well as this link, all those things from where you can install the APM and all commands will be there. You can just go through and watch it. That if you face any kind of issue, do let me know. And make sure this step should be in the sequence. It should not like that you install first Android Studio, then you are going to install the Java. It will not work at all. First install the JDK, Oracle JDK, not OpenJDK, and then install APM, Android Studio, then install APM. Don't miss the any kind of sequence. I know this video got extended, but yes, it's a kind of setup. People used to take around 1 or 2 days to install these things and make it a complete setup ready. So it will take time. It's a panic job to install. So very soon I will come up with the Docker image. I will create my Docker image and I will push in the Docker Hub so that this image, what it will do, I'm planning to do this and I already working on this. So what the image will do, once you cloning that Docker image automatically, once you are installing that image or running the container, then automatically it will take your, it will install your Android, Java, JDK, and it will set the path in your local system. And again, it will install the, and automatically it will install the Android Studio. It will set the path automatically. It will install the Linux Gnu, NPM and APM, all those things. It will set the path. This image will do these things. So that I'm planning to do, I'll very soon I'll come up with the same Docker image and I'll push in publicly in my Docker Hub account and you guys can clone it up, right? So yes, Brew is installing. You can see this Brew glass is coming, right? So it's saying that the Brew is getting installed, right? So all those things is getting set now. Yes, Brew has been installed. Now the thing is that we have to install the node, right? So just update that Brew. So there is, yes, it already updated and now install the node. So again, it might be get fail, but don't be panic. If it will get fail, don't be panic. I will give you the another solution as well. Okay, so let's see if it is getting installed, then fine. Most probably 90% cases I found with the Brew and node is getting installed successfully, right? But if you are installed, if it will get failed, then I have some solution for that. Okay. I'll show you what to do. I guess this time it will work. So 90%, it is, this case is coming under the 90%. So if in your case, if it is getting failed, then you are, your luck, bad luck is that. But don't worry, comment in the section if you are not able to install the node with the help of the Brew command, then let me know. I will give you the another solution, right? And then we have to link the Brew and it is getting downloaded. Oh, wait a minute, it's a node, all the packages getting downloaded. So you can see again, beer command is coming, means node has been downloaded successfully. Now brew command is running and all those things and node packages are getting installed. Yes, installing node. Can you see this command, installing node, and node has been installed successfully. Now we have to link this. Yes, it got linked also. Now we have to install the APM. Okay, so make sure NPM, now NPM command. See, now I haven't installed node separately. I installed with the help of the Brew. So just install APM and now I'm installing the APM. Let's see if it will work, then fine. If it will not work, then don't be panic. I have another solution. You can do that. I will show you that solution as well. So let it to be download, let it to be installed, VPM with the help of the NPM node package. NPM is just basically stands for node package manager. So basically with this command, what we are trying to do, NPM install APM and hyphen G is what it's saying, globally we are installing. Means APM command we can use globally across this system, anywhere. Means anywhere we can use this APM command. So that I'm giving the argument like hyphen G. Hyphen G means globally we can access this APM command, right? So it got installed, but yes, as expected, we getting some issues. Let's see how we can fix these things. Yes, we are getting some error, but don't worry. If it is not working at all, so I was knowing it will not work, to what to do, basically. So it's fine, it's throwing another. So there is APM official desktop. You can install the APM desktop, right? So there is an official website of APM desktop and go to there and download this 1.18.2. There are many versions is there, you can install anything, but I feel 1.18.2 is very stable version. you can download this and you can see this. If you are using the Linux, then you can use this thing, this image, app image. Or if you are using the Mac file, then you can install this DMG file. So as of now, I am using the Linux operating system. Then I'm going to download this file. Okay. So it is getting downloaded. It's 137 MB. So it will take some time of 1 or 2 minutes. So let it to be downloaded. So meanwhile, if you are facing any kind of issue, guys, please do comment. I'll resolve this. Put your comment. Then, so let it to be download, and once it get downloaded, then I will show you what to do. Right. Let me pause the recording. Meanwhile, okay. So my app image got installed or downloaded. So what to do? Go to this directory. Where is that? Just Control X and keep inside of download section. So it should be all on the same face. So I always recommend to download and copy inside of your some folder. But anyway, I am keeping all those things in my download section. So what to do? This app image got downloaded. Next thing is that we have to make it as a executable, right? So how to do that? Sudo download. Go to the download. Sudo chmod command hyphen r for reading that, and this is the apm. It's not taking. Sudo chmod hyphen r 777 and this app image, and you can read this. Yes. And now if you can press the ls command, and you can see it become green, right? And now if you want to execute this dot apm and run this, so it should start the apm server. Yes, cool, your part has been done and apm server got installed, and apm got installed and server got also initialized the things. So hope you guys understood and hope you guys like this video. This is the installation of APM from the scratch. If you have a completely new system and how to start the APM in your Ubuntu or Mac operating system, you can just follow this instruction and it will work. And all those commands I will pass in my description. You can follow those things. Thank you for watching this video, guys. And we spend much time on this. If you really like this video, then please do subscribe the channel so that never miss the update. Thank you.